This book is based on a lot of research and surveys. And in one of these, we surveyed more than 1,000 workers and asked them, are you experiencing well-being at your work? And 1 in 5 were, but for 4 in 5, there were some blockers that stopped them fully thriving. So we tallied up the top 10 blockers, and 6 of the 10 were to do with leadership or management issues. That's what caused the block. Another 3 in 10 were to do with problematic workplace culture, which the leaders, of course, will set. So 9 of the top 10 blockers to us thriving at work were because of poor leadership or management approaches. Therefore, leaders are the key enablers of well-being at work, or the key blockers of it. Those old authoritarian styles, you know, the leader saying, you know, firings will continue until morale improves. You know, it's never going to bring about a workplace culture of flourishing and thriving. Yes, leaders have to drive strategy. But more important than that, the starting point of that is creating the right culture. We say it's more important than having a vision for the organization is having a vision for your team. Shaping the culture, creating well-being, and from there, the strategy will flow. We used in an image for this book, and it's on the cover, the shapes you get if you drop a rock on a pond, you get the ripples, the concentric circles flowing out. And we said, the success of a leader is determined not by what they achieve in their tenure, but by what they set in motion. If we can get the culture right, have a vision for the next generation, train them up well, the ripples, the flow continue long after we have moved on to another leadership role. Leaders are key to creating well-being at work. In fact, they're essential.